Okay, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah. Okay. Okay, the reason why I record this one is for a few reasons. Among others, basically when I die, okay, this is a preparation of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The main purpose is basically I want to leave something that people can still benefit from whatever I leave. You know, I left something that people will benefit. It's like, if you go somewhere so far, okay, then you need to have a lot of things to bring with you. Okay, it's like it's not my last word though. Inshallah, Allah will make my life longer. I mean, at least until 63, as the age of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which only have about seven years to go. So that's the main purpose. Okay, so when I record my lecture, basically, others will be able to benefit from it as well. Okay, and that's basically a long-term objective. Okay, long-term objective. When I die, that people can still benefit from me. You know, so people can get some, you know, ideas, whatever it is. Okay, that's the long objective, long-term objective. Okay, the short-term one, maybe you can benefit from it. Okay, if let's say you feel lazy to read, for example, okay, and then you watch the video and also it can be considered. I take into consideration, let's say if you don't want to read, let's say 2 hours, I think you think too much, and then you go and find any videos that is related to your subject, then you listen to it, not listening and watching at the same time playing games. No. It cannot be counted. Okay, you must concentrate on your videos and then understand from it and get benefit from the videos. Okay, that's also can be considered within that 2 hours, inshallah. Okay? Inshallah. Okay? Okay, can we start?
Yes.
Alright. We start now. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We have listened to very good tazkirah just now, inshallah. Baba and what? And the customer. Okay, and the customer. Don't blame Allah if anything happens to you. Because why? Because Allah is there. If you're not looking for Him, you are not seeking Him. Okay, you're not seeking His blessings and all that. You are the one who to be blamed, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? A'udzubillahi minasyaitanir rajim. We start with this one, Arkan al-Jarimah. Okay, Arkan al-Jarimah. أركان الجريمة يراد بروك الشرع النص الذي يجرم السلوك إيجابا أو سلبا. Okay, when we say it is جريمة, there must be a nas. Okay, there must be a nas, a text from Quran or Hadith saying that is or the action or the omission is basically against the law and is جريمة. If there is no nas, no text in the Quran, no text in the Hadith saying that particular action is jarima, then we cannot simply say it is jarima. Okay? It's not easy for us to decide what is jarima, what is not, unless what is prescribed by the Quran. Okay, we cannot simply say, oh, this is jarima, or catch this one, okay, arrest this one, and put this in jail, and kill this one because he's committing something which is against our will, maybe, but if not against Allah's will, then we cannot say it's jarima. Okay, it's very simple concept about jarima. Okay, and not just saying the Quran say, the Nas say, okay, this is jarima. On top of that, the Quran also say there are some punishment for this one. For this particular action, it's jarima. Number one is against Sharia law, and at the same time, it's also come with together with the punishment. Then only then we can say it is jarima. Okay. So, an tariq al ijab aw al sab. Ijab. What is ijab?
Positive.
Yes. It's part of it. Yes, the meaning of ijab. Yes, it's positive. What is when it comes to law, Sharia law? Ijab it means what? Committing something or commission. Or committing something against Sharia law, this commission is considered as ijab. Commission means you need to act, you need to do something. If you don't do anything, then it's not considered as jinayah in terms of ijab. Ijab means you need to commit something, and then only then, because it is jinayah. You need to kill somebody, that action. If you don't kill, then you cannot be called as a killer or a murderer. You need to kill, for example. As omission, you need to abstain yourself or, you know, not doing something which is you are obliged to do so. Let's say if you are taking care of a kid, for example, and then you don't give food for them, for the children, for example, and you lock them up in the room, and then you don't give food, don't give drinks and everything, and then because of that, because of your omission, because of you not doing what you're supposed to do, and then it can cause death to the children, and then this omission is considered as crime. Okay? Is it okay? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. وَالْهَذَا فَإِنَّهُ إِذَا لَمْ يَرِدْ نَصْ يَجْرِمُ السُّلُوكُ فَهُوَ السُّلُوكُ مُبَاحٌ طَالَمَا لَمْ يَتَرَتَّبْ عَلِيهِ مُضَارَةٌ Okay, as long as the action is not stated in the Quran or Hadith saying that it's jarima, and then it states at least it's not jarima. As long as it does not cause any harm to people. Okay? But basically, if you can say, if anything that can harm to people, then definitely it falls under something which is against the law. You know, something that is good cannot be considered as jinayah. Something good, something which is good, when it is good, then it cannot against Sharia law. And of course, it cannot be said as jarima, as we can understand it. But the principle is like that. If something is bad, of course it cause harm to other people or to yourself, even, and it also can be considered as jarima. And as a general principle, when you talk about jarima, there must be mudarah. There must be some type of harm, something harmful action. Okay. فهو إذا عمل مجرم طبقا لما ورده في النهي عن المضارعه فبقول رسول الله لا ضرر ولا ضرر. If you do something that is against Sharia law, which can cause harmfulness to other people or to yourself, then it falls under لا ضرر ولا ضرر. لا ضرر ولا ضرر. And then when there is some مضارعه, any harmful, you know, happen to you or to yourself or to even to animals, also can be considered as jarima. Alright? Okay, anyone interested to come forward? Come in the front of, you know, the stage, on the stage, and then replace me for a while. Anyone interested? No? Anyone? Yeah, you be on camera, you know? Anyone? No? Okay. Then if you don't want, then make sure your eyes are open. Okay. I know it's hot. Okay, it's hot. And then, afternoon class like this, you know, so it's very tiring, very hot, and then very stressful, and it'll be very boring. So, okay, are you boring?
No.
Say so, no problem, huh? Okay, no problem. Be honest to yourself. All right, okay. Now, والحديث عن الركن الشرعي يتطلب بيان ما يجب أن يتوفر للنص التشريعي من سمات تتمثل فيما يأتي من كونه أولا نافذا وقت وقوع الجريمة. Okay, when you talk about al-rukn al-shar'i, you said earlier on, when you talk about al-rukn al-shar'i, meaning that in every jinayah, in every crime, it needs a text specifying the crime itself. I mean, there is must be text. For example, we take one example, al-zani to al-zani, fajlidu kulla wahidin minhuma mi'ata jalda. So the ayah actually is talking about zina and its punishment. So there is nas, yes, there is nas. There is a specific punishment for this, the zina, yes, it's specific nas for this. Okay, it's describe the punishment for zina, for example. This is a ruknu ash-shar'i, meaning that anything, any action cannot be considered as jinaya if there is no nas or text saying it is jarima. This is considered as a ruknu ash-shar'i. Ruknu shar'i, to make it easy for you to understand, is any crime must have nas. If no nas, no crime. As simple as that. Okay? As simple. This is a ruknu. A ruknu means anything cannot be considered as jinayah if there is no text from the Quran. This is considered a ruknu. A ruknu. Meaning that if we say in the salah, for example, If ruknu is not being fulfilled, then the solat is invalid. Something. So same goes to crime. The crime if without rukun, then the crime cannot be considered as crime. Alright? Understand that?
Yes.
Okay. There are few elements. There are three elements of rukun al-shar'i. Okay. Awalan nafidan waqta wuqu' al-jarimah. Okay, I will explain briefly here, and then later we go to details. نافذاً وقت وقوع الجريمة بمعنى أنه حينما يقع أو حينما حدث أو حدثت الجناية. Whenever the crime occurs, okay, when the crime, any crime, any type of crime occurs, there must be a specific law or Qur'aniyah, ayah Qur'aniyah or hadith already in place. Okay, before anything happens. Before any jarima happens, it must be nas there already. Meaning that if any crime that happened after the revelation, okay, if after the existence of the ayah, before after the existence of text saying this is jarima, this is the punishment for this and that, only then the person who commit this crime can be punished. Which means that if, for example, someone commit zina. Before the revelation, let's say yesterday he committed zina, and at that particular time there is no specific law or specific provision saying that anyone who commits zina must be stoned to death or must be given 100 lashes, for example. There is no text there when it happened. Okay, and then after they commit zina today, then come the revelation. Okay, revelation come today saying that anyone who the ayah that we stated just now, anyone who is not married, a zaniya to a zani, and then he must be given, or he, she must be given 100 lashes, okay, or stroke. So in this case, can this person who commit zina be punished with the new punishment, a new hukum or new hukuba? Cannot. Because why? Because when it happens, the nurse is not there yet. So you understand?
Yes.
Understand the text? Yes. Nafidha waqtu wuqu' al-jarimah. The ayah, the hukum can be implemented there and then when it happens. Okay. If the hukum is not yet there, and then cannot be used the new hukum. Okay. And then secondly, sariyan ala makan wuqu'iha. Sariyan ala makan wuqu'iha. بمعنى أنه إذا كان الجريمة حدثت في دولة غير دولة إسلامية فلا عقوبة على من ارتكب هذه الجريمة. Understand? Okay, understand. So it must be in the territory of Islamic law, Islamic state. If it's beyond Islamic state, أو خارج بلاد الإسلام أو بلاد الإسلام أو دولة إسلامية فلا عقوبة على المرتكب إلا إذا رجع. If he comes back, for example, someone. If considering that Malaysia is an Islamic state, for example, and then somebody committed the crime in Singapore, for example, okay, then the government knows that he's committing the crime, he committed the crime, and then with evidence or that, he only can be punished when he comes back, because in Singapore, basically, it's not an Islamic state. Okay, well, that's the example. Only when he comes back, only then he can be punished. Okay? This is sariyan ala makan wuqu'iha, bima'na al-shari'ah al-islamiyah mutabbaqa, and on al-shari'ah al-islamiyah only can be implemented in Islamic state, not kharij Islamic states. Okay? Okay, thalithan mulzaman al-shakhs alladhi waqat minhu, and anyone who commit the crime, only he or she is deserved to be punished, not anyone else. And there is no difference between someone who is poor, someone who is rich, someone with position, no position, normal people, leaders, and all that. No one is accepted. I mean, cannot be excluded. Cannot be excluded basically from any type of punishment when it happens. Okay? There's no difference between one person to another, regardless of their position. Okay, this is mulzaman li shakhs alladhi waqa'at fihi. That's the meaning of this one. But, right. Now we go a bit details about the first element, which is نَبِذَ الْوَقْتُ وَقُوعَ الْجَرِيمَةِ. اتَّفَقَ رِجَالُ الْقَانُونَ عَلَى عَدَمِ السِّرِيَانِ الْقَوَانِيَ الْجِنَائِيَّةِ إِلَّا عَلَى مَا يَقَعْ اعْتِبَارًا مِنْ تَارِكِ الْعَمَلِ بِهَا. Okay, so this is according to people of Al-Qanun. Rijal Al-Qanun meaning people who are expert in the law. For example, maybe lawyers, maybe judges, okay? These experts basically in opinion that a jinaya, okay? لا يقع إلا من تاريخ العمل. Meaning that only if the crime happens when the hukum is already there, as we explained earlier on. So basically, if the crime happens before the existence of the law, and then someone cannot be punished with that particular law. Okay, this is the meaning of this one. Same like we explained before this. Okay. ولا يترتب القانونيين لا أثر فيما وقع قبل صدورها. Okay, anything that happens before the revelation, then we cannot use the new law to apply to the thing that happened before the existence of the law. والعمل بها إلا إذا حال إما إذا كان في هذا ذاك نفع للمتهم الذي لا يتم الحكم عليه بصورة نهائية. Except, okay, in this case there is some exception. Okay, whereby we need and we must. Okay, use the new law to be implemented to something that happened in the past, which is when it happened there is no law yet. Okay, there is some exception. We're going to talk about it later. Okay, for example here, the example قَالُوا اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَلَا تَنْكِحُوا مَا نَكَحَ آبَاؤُكُمْ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ إِلَّا مَا قَدْ سَلَفَ إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَمَقْتًا وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. This is an example of the ayah, which says that, you know, it's prohibited for someone to get married with the ex-wife or the father. وَلَا تَنْكِحُوا مَا نَكَحَ آبَاؤُكُمْ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ إِلَّا مَا قَدْ سَلَفَ, except what had happened before. Okay, before the revelation of ayah, azani tu azani, fajibdu kulla wahid minhuma ila akhir ayah. Before this revelation, before the revelation, someone, you know, the son can basically get married with the ex-wife or the father. Before this, okay. Now, what happened if yesterday, same example, yesterday someone, you know, a person got married with the ex-wife or the father yesterday. And then come today, the ayah saying that azanati was zani, and then the marriage is no longer considered as valid. Today, yesterday was valid because there is no rules, and today it become invalid. And what happened to this marriage? Okay, then later we talk about the consequences of this type of marriage. Okay. And then also, Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَنْ تَجْمَعُوا بَيْنَ الْأُخْتَيْنِ إِلَّا مَا قَدْ سَلَفَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And also you cannot gather two siblings, two sisters for them in one marriage. You cannot. But previously it can. Same goes to the example, this one. Okay, someone got married with, they gather together, let's say four or five together, you know, all the siblings, same, you know, mothers and fathers, siblings, okay, they are married. They are married with girls from the same family yesterday. Then come ayah saying azani to azani ila akhir ayah. And also, that means, how about the punishment for them? How about the marriage? Yesterday the marriage was okay. Yesterday the marriage was considered as valid. Now it's no longer valid. But what is the consequences of it? Okay, what if it happened now? After the existence of the law, of course, when it happened after the existence of the law, then they will be punished with the new law. But this one, we are talking about something that happened before, happened yesterday, happened the day before, for example. Okay, then we see this here. فالآية الأولى حرمت أو حرمت نكاح زوجات الأب وذلك منذ نزل هذه الآية وبيان أنه فاحشة. This is explained. As we see in here, harimat nikah zaujat lab. We can see the prohibition of getting married with the ex-wife or the father. Okay, it's clear. As we explained just now, either anwa min al muharamat tahrim jam' bayna ukhtayn. We can gather one sibling, sisters, for example, together in one marriage. You want to get married another one, you need to divorce her, and then after the end of the iddah, and then you can marry another one. Yes, you can, but you cannot get the two at the same time. Okay. Okay, that is hukum. فهذه النصوص وما يماثلها يبين منهما ما وضحت الشريعة الإسلامية من قواعد الأصول الشرعية تحكم العمل في تطبيق النص الجنائي وتقضي بأنه لا يجرم. Okay, this is the most important point we are going to highlight here. لا يجرم سلوك إلا بعد ورود النص الذي يجرمه. بمعنى أنه السلوك الفعل. Okay, الفعل لا يكون مجرما. الفعل أي فعل either commission or omission cannot be considered as a crime unless there is حديث النص الذي يجرمه الذي يعني يجعله هذا جريمة. If there is no text saying this is جريمة, you cannot say it is جريمة. This is quite it is considered as one of the principle in Sharia law. Is it clear so far?
Yes.
All right. Is this still hot?
Yes.
I don't feel hot at all. Why? I don't feel like, you know, using the word, whatever it is, you know, like a fan, something like that, you know, handmade fan, you know. Why? Why is it friend between you and me? Sorry? I'm old? Yeah, I know, I'm old, no? So old people don't feel hot? They do. It's here. It's in here. You are not strong. You are not strong enough here. Yes. If you are strong enough, you don't really care about the surrounding. You just focus on the you know, the lecture, and then you just forget about everything, you know, what happened outside, you know, the world. Okay? Hot, yes, I feel it, but I don't really care. I don't give a focus on it, you know. I don't feel like, oh, it's okay. It's hot, yeah, it's hot, so what? And then you just relax and then focus and then, yeah. If you keep doing like this, and then you feel like always complaining, oh, so hot, so, and then you do concentrate into my lecture. That's the danger of it. Okay? So concentrate. Feel like, wow, we are in the beach, you know. There's lights, the wind, you know, coming, it's so smooth and then so bright. Ah, so nice, feels so nice, you know? You know? Try to imagine that. Okay. But sometimes it's not easy though. It's not easy, yeah? But never mind. Just focus on it. See, something we have only 2 hours, yeah? Not long, you know. I can go up to 4 hours, no problem. With this condition. Okay? With a smile in my face. Still. Even though sweating, you know. Alright? Okay. Oh, maybe because I'm glad I'm here. The door, I know it's open, and then, you know, the air, the fresh air coming in. Okay. Yeah, maybe makes a difference. You want to change? Come here. I go up there. Alright. Okay. Don't make it too seriously. Just relax, you know. If you want to stand up, okay, you can go around. Okay, fine. Today is a free class, you know. You can sit down, you can, yeah, sit on the stairs, yeah, staircase here, yeah, oh, please. Make yourself comfortable. Yeah, seriously, no problem. Okay? If you feel like sitting here by the window, yeah, okay, go. Yes. You want to sit here? You can also. Open the doors and all doors, you know. You can sit. Come. Yeah, serious. You can go everywhere you want, no problem. As long as you are in this class, it's okay. You can go around, but sit quietly. And then you can move around, no problem. Eh? I know it's not easy to control your mind, you know. It's hot, you know. Especially, you know, everybody, all of you, you know, sitting always on the air condition at home, you know, in the kampong, all this air condition, you know, everywhere you go, you know. Like me, I'm a kampong man, you know. So you know, that's why I get used to it. You know? All right, okay. We can start. We can carry on. Okay, anyone want to go and get a shower first and then come back? Okay, you can do. Oh, you want to go and get a shower? Should you? Okay, please. Are you to sit here? Okay, bismillah. Okay, we continue, right? Okay. Another element is sariyat ala makan hukumnya, as we mentioned earlier. Okay, here, this is the important point here. Adam usul sultat al-dawla al-islamiyah min haith ila haithu al-imun. Meaning that if you are in now in Islamic State. Okay, for example, any crime that happened in this Islamic State can be implemented Sharia law. Otherwise, it cannot be implemented. Okay, that's a simple explanation for this one. Okay, and qasam al-fuqaha. Okay, al-fuqaha divided al-bilad ila dar al-Islam wa dar al-haram. Okay, when we talk about Islamic State, and then there must be Islamic, non-Islamic State, which is, we call it Dar al-Harb. Dar al-Harb. There is Dar al-Islam and Dar al-Harb. Okay? وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ زَالَ دَارُ الْأَحْدِ. And then the people say, some of them divided into three, which added Dar al-Ahd. Okay? Dar al-Ahd meaning that there is some sort of agreement between the Islamic State and the other state. They are not Harb, which we cannot go and, you know, beat them or kill them. You cannot go and fight with them, but you have some sort of agreement, you know, between the country. That they call Dar al-Ahd. Amma Dar al-Islam, Dar al-Tajri alayha Ahkam al-Islam. Okay, Ahkam al-Lati, Dar al-Lati Tajri alayha Ahkam al-Islam. Before this, we had some discussion about whether Malaysia is an Islamic state or not, right? And then some of you say yes, it is Islamic State, some say no, Malaysia is not an Islamic State. Okay, if you're looking at this one, and then we look at this, our country, Malaysia, whether it's comply with this or not, then we can decide whether it's Islamic law, Islamic State or not. If you look at this one, الدار التي تجري عليها أحكام الإسلام. So basically, if the state or the country is governed by Islamic law, the whole Islamic law in all aspects of the country or the administration of the country, then only then it can be considered as an Islamic state. Otherwise, you can say Islamic state, but in actual fact, it is not an Islamic state. Alright? ويأمن ثم بعد ذلك دار الإسلام. Okay. ويأمن من فيها بأمان المسلمين سواء كانوا مسلمين أو ذميين. When we say it's Malaysia for example an Islamic state, then the obligation of the Islamic state is to protect anyone. It need to make everybody in that Islamic state feel free and have the peace and, you know, not been disturbed, not been you know, done something which is against their will. For example, even they are non-Muslim. So we cannot simply kill them, we cannot simply hurt them, we cannot simply take their wealth or the property away. Cannot. Because they have some sort of protection against anything that can hurt them. Okay? They call al-dhimmiyin. Those who are in the Islamic State, basically if we consider ourselves as an Islamic State, then anyone who lives in this Islamic State, who are not Muslim, is considered al-dhimmiyin. Dhimmiyin, people who are not Muslim but complying with the law of that particular country. This is called dhimmiyin. Okay? We cannot say people are now saying, okay, DAP is Harbi. Is it true? Anyone say DAP is Kafir Harbi, then can be fought and can be killed, and then, you know, it's halal to kill them. Who said that? Never mind. Some mufti say so. Some mufti say so, yes. Anyone agree with the mufti of Pahang, I think? One of the mufti, anyone from Pahang? Yeah, mufti of Pahang issued a fatwa, you know, a long time ago, that the AP basically is against Sharia law. It's basically, they can be considered as Kafir Harbi, and then they can be killed. That according to one fatwa issued by the Mufti of Pahang, one of the Muftis. Okay, anyone agree with that? Anyone? Do you agree with that? Huh? You don't agree. Why?
Because it bounds by our country's rule.
Okay, we have our own rule, and as long as they do not, I agree with you. I mean, why should, what happened? Okay? Thank you. We are not supporting DAPs, okay? Because whatever DAP do, basically, as long as... We supporting, I rephrase again. We supporting anyone that comply with the rules of the country. As simple as that. Anyone at all. And we take any good things from anyone, as long as not against the Sharia law. That's the principle. That is the principle. And then we reject any bad thing from anyone. Whether they are rulers, whether they are prime ministers, that doesn't matter. As long as they do something against Sharia law, then we go against it. Through the proper way, of course. Through the channel, certain channel, which is provided by the country. Okay, we're going to simply say, oh, this is Kafir Harbi, and then let's go and fight them. Kill them. Oh, they don't deserve to be here. No, it's wrong. This is Malaysia, created by whom? You created it? My forefather, you know, created it? Our ancestor created it? No. Who created the Malaysia? Who created Malaysia? Allah created Malaysia. Okay, who decided that in this country there will be Chinese, there will be Sikh, there will be Hindus, there will be Muslim, of course. Who decided? Is it us who decide? No, it's Allah. It's the land of Allah. Allah created it. Allah decided who will be residing in this country. Not us. Okay. What right do we have to say, oh, they are immigrants. They come and try to invade our country and then take all the wealth and then, you know, do this and that. Can we do that? Can we say that? No, cannot. Even though they're Chinese, originally Chinese, but they come to Malaysia and then become Malaysian citizens. And they have the same right as we have. And it's against Sharia law. If you are talking about like Maqasid al-Sharia, okay, among other Maqasid is basically protecting the religion. Okay, of course, Islam comes not to protect the religion of others, but it's only protecting Islam. But basically, if you don't protect other religion from any type of, let's say, encroachment or any type of things that against the religion, so in return, our religion will be affected. For example, if you go to the church, you throw the stone and then you break all the windows, everything. Okay, now, are we protecting the religion or not? Are we just leave like that happen? Can we let this happen? Anyone just go and destroy the churches and then the other places of worship? No, we cannot do that. Because what if we do that, people will come and attack us, our mosque. And then, if that means also it falls under the protection of religion. Because we want to protect our religion, so we avoid ourselves from doing something that can hurt other people. So not because to avoid them coming back and attack us. So that's part of Maqasid Sharia. But we are of course not accepting the religion. We do not accept the Aqidah. Because the Aqidah is of course is not acceptable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only Islam that we accept by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we cannot simply do something which can cause the harm to other people, so that's actually to avoid other people to do harm to ourselves. Okay? So this is Islam. This is Islam. So there is Darul Haq, of course, Darul Haq is, of course, there are countries that now basically nowadays we don't have this type of Darul Haq. Except if we can say maybe in Gaza, and Israel, maybe it's Darul Haq, because they keep fighting and they keep killing our people, our brothers and sisters in Gaza, for example, then they can be considered as Darul Haq. But the problem is, we are so weak. We're going to fight them back. Okay, what happened to Gaza? They're being caught, they're being killed, they're being bombarded. The bombardment, you know, happened every time, everywhere. In Gaza, for example, then we don't have strength to fight back. That's the problem. And we are not united among Muslims in the world. So that's just our problems, okay? Okay. Thumma biladul Islam kullaha tu'taba darun wahidah. Okay, if we're talking about Islamic law, okay, about Islamic state is in only one state. Okay, for example, now we have differences between Pahang, Kelantan, Negeri Sembilan, and Johor, and all part of the country. State, we have our enactments. Okay, different enactment. In Kelantan, there is a different enactment. In Pahang, for example, it's different. For example, in Kedah, it's also different. But now, if Malaysia become an Islamic state, all will be unified. Okay, everything will be one. Okay, only one type of law which will govern all state of Malaysia. Then is the nature of Islamic states. Okay. ولو اختلفت حكامها وصارت دولا شتى لنفوذ حكم الإسلام فيها لأن هذه الفرقة لا تقضي على نفوذ حكم الإسلام فيها جميعا أما okay. So basically even though they, we have rulers for example in all states, but when Islam come, when we consider or we declare for example Malaysia is an Islamic state, then it will become one type of rule. Only one type of rule, even though the rulers and the those who actually govern the country, basically different leaders, okay, but they are actually applying the same law, the same rule. Okay, this is the nature of Islamic states. Okay. وأما دار الحق هي دار التي لا سلطان للمسلمين عليها وهي دار التي شوكتها لأهل الكفر ولا سلطان عليهم. Meaning that if we are talking about Darul Harb, meaning that there is no authority of Islam. Islam has no authority. Islamic state has no authority in the Islamic in the Darul Harb, and therefore we cannot apply the Islamic law. Okay, wadih? Okay. ثم ملزما للشخص الذي وقعت منه سوى الله سبحانه وتعالى بين الناس في أصل الخلق فالناس جميعا أبناء آدم. Nabi Adam alaihi salam wajalla Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala asas al-mufadalah bainahum wahidan wa taqwa. Okay, there are people in the eyes of Allah are the same. People are the same, regardless man or woman, regardless of whether you are black or white or whatever it is, as long as you are Muslim, then you are in front of Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala is the same. What makes you different from others is your taqwa. If you want to get, you know, a close relation to Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be the most taqwa of you. If you are, if the taqwa is stronger, you are closer to Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. If your taqwa is lower, and then you are far away from Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alright? Okay. وهذا ما اقتضم به الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وأكده لكل لا فضل لعربي على أعجمي إلا بالتقوى. There is no difference between Arab and non-Arab except with taqwa. Okay? ثم بعد ذلك نتكلم عن ركن المادي للجريمة. We have done with ركن الشرعي. Now we are talking about ركن المادي للجريمة. الركن المادي للجريمة هو مظهر الجريمة المجسد الناتج عما دار في فؤاد المرتكب الجريمة قبل وقوعها. Okay, ركن المادي وقيامه بسلوك تسبب في وقوع الجريمة وتحققها. Okay. The meaning of rukn al-maddi is something that is actually the action. The action. I mean the action, either action, when we talk about action, it's not just action which is a commission and as well as omission. Two type of action here. So it started with how it started. Someone who actually killed somebody, how it started? It goes straight kill without planning, without anything? Oh, there must be some planning. There must be some intention. Yes. So rukn al-maddi is the result of the intention. Okay, the result of intention. So if you have the intention alone, you have intention because you get married, you get angry. For example, not married. You get angry with somebody because of some reason. Now, if you are talking about people at your age, for example, fighting for a boyfriend or a girlfriend. Okay, happens. Yeah, it happens. Someone you said you are targeting for example one girl, and then you aim for her, you really like her, you know, you do everything to, you know, to tackle her for example, you know, to like the intention of her. You did everything. At the same time, there's another one who also admire her. Okay, and then do the same. Try to get tackling her and only get, you know, intention from her and all that. And then you come to know that, oh, there is some competitor there. And then how to get her? And it happened here? Happened in Yusim? Yeah. Yes? Oh my God. Happened here? Okay? Just run away. Go and find somebody else. Don't fight, please. Don't fight, alright? So what happened? People are sometimes willing to each other. Yes, don't kill, don't kill. Yes, please. Okay? Go find someone else who is better. You know, don't fight for the sake of man or woman. It's crazy, right? Okay? Okay? Can I accept that? Millions of people in this world, millions of men and women in this world, why you should go and fight for one person? What guarantee can you get? What guarantee can you get? First thing, you are not married yet. What guarantee can you get? If you fight, what guarantee? She will get married with you. One thing. If she is willing to get married with you, what guarantee that you get happiness through this marriage? What guarantee? What guarantee?
Jutaan terima kasih kerana menonton video ini. Jika ia bermanfaat, sila like, share dan subscribe. Salam khawatir dari saya, Ustaz Dr. Nik Rahim bin Nik Wajiz. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.